You had video come out before we go to break where you wanted to encourage people to get tested, and some people are afraid it's going to hurt. So you had video of it that I want to show the audience of you actually getting tested. Here it is. There's you. You were kind of funny, and they were testing you. Now, a few questions about this process. First of all, is it true that when you were having the test administered, you inhaled and the doctor's finger went all the way up your nose and got stuck and had to be released with a tool? Is that true? Just to deal with the record.
She wanted to comment that I have a little button nose, and she was afraid that the swab would actually hurt because it extended my nasal cavity.
The proboscis issue.
She was speaking about the delicacy
of the nose. Yes. And that's what, you know what, I understand. This is the normal swab I'm holding up here now and for everybody at home. A very valuable object. There's only one company in the entire country that makes these up in Maine. All right, here's the swab. Is it true that this was the swab that the nurse was actually using on you, and that at first it went into your nose and disappeared, so that in scale, this was the actual swab that was being used to fit up that double barrel shotgun that you have mounted on the front of your pretty face?
See, I said I was going to be nice and sweet.
I just want a yes, no. Was it this?
I was trying.
Or was it this?
Very hard. Look.
Which was it?
You know, first, I thought I did so well on that nasal test standing up there. She did the swab. I did not flinch. I was a cool dude in a loose mood. Didn't move.
Of course
anything.
You were.
I was happy.
That swab is like a piece of lint going in that thing in your face.
How could
it have collected anything?
Not.
It was like throwing a rock around a cave.
That is so not right.
Was it this?
That is just not
right. Or was it
this?
Tell people the truth. Come on. Love
Gov. That is not right.
Come on. Which was
it? This is not love. This is not love.
Listen. I just want to get it. I'm going to take a break because if you're not going to answer questions, I'm going to have to reset. I thought there'd be a little bit more transparency for the audience. I'll put it to them online. You know, this is the regular swab. This is what we're told disappeared in the governor's nose. And then we were told that this is what it took. We're going to take a break. When we come back, something that everybody wants to know, second to what I just asked. What is reopening going to look like in New York State? And what would be the triggers for the state to say, no, this is what we were worried about? Is it a number? Is it a feel? Is it a political calculus? What is it going to look like, and what changes might come based on what going forward? Important for everybody to know. We'll be right back. When people ask, should I still get a test to see if I'm positive or negative, or should I get the antibody test? What's your guidance?
My guidance. First, I want you to know, I'm glad you just moved on. I have a screen here, and I can see what you do now on that screen.
So what are you referring?
And
when the
I
commercial
so...
break comes, it's like nothing happened before it. What are you referring to?
Oh, I see. I see. Well, that happened.
Life what
happened? The world
I don't know what
round.
You're talking about. But just please continue.
FAQ, yeah, you don't know. You don't know. We'll take it up. Yeah.
Go ahead.
Okay. The antibody test tells you if you had the virus and if you recovered. Theoretically, for those people who believe there's an immunity, if you have the antibodies, then that theory would pertain if you take the antibody test. You have the antibodies. At one time, they said if you have the antibodies, you can't get the virus again. Now they're changing the facts on that, and there's an ambiguity. The diagnostic test tells you whether or not you have it today. So there are two different purposes. We use both, obviously, depending on what you're trying to determine. If you're just trying to test the positive level of a given community who has had it, or an individual who wants to know whether or not they have it today. So they're two different tests for two different purposes.
What kind of rate going up would be enough for you to reassess whether or not you have to take remedial action, slow down, back off? Do you have any markers? How do you measure that?
Yeah, it's a good question.
Thank you.
The first thing we have, I was just being kind. It was rhetorical.
It was rhetorical, I know, but I take it when I get it. Go ahead. Go ahead. I'm sorry. I didn't mean to interrupt. Go ahead.
Okay. I'm sorry. We have experts who are We have experts, literally international experts. We have domestic experts. And they will watch the calibration. You start to see numbers go up. First of all, you want to make sure it's not a normal deviation, because this whole system was just put in place. You have a day-to-day deviation. Second, you want to make sure it's not a cluster situation where you have a hot spot or one cluster that's raising the numbers, which is actually better than just a community spread. And then you would attack that cluster.
If tracing, you have a community spread. That's why you keep emphasizing tracing. You need tracing for that. Go ahead. Continue.
Yeah, I haven't emphasized tracing, but you do. It's testing, and you see the increase in the testing. And then what is the percentage of the increase? Can you handle that increase vis-a-vis your hospital capacity, right? Because that's the number on the other side of the equation. And then can you tamp it down, or do you need to dial back? And that's on a case-by-case basis. Obviously, we haven't been here before, and obviously, nobody's done this before. So you watch it day to day on the numbers.
How dangerous a political calculation is that? All joking aside, you know, you start to see hospitalization rates. I think that's the metric that makes the most sense. It's the most acute metric of what's changing in a community. So it starts to go up. And the number is appreciable enough that the clinicians in that place start talking about it. Local leaders start talking about it. They come to you. If you back off reopening, that is a dangerous political decision, especially during the summertime. You know, people are so desperate to get back, and to have things taken away from them can come with a cost. How do you calibrate that?
First, the hospitalization rate, not to be difficult, is one of the indicators. But there's a lag on the hospitalization rate. There's about a 2-week lag. You get infected today, you don't wind up in a hospital for about 2 weeks. So actually, the diagnostic testing is the primary device. But look, the politics on all of this are treacherous. This is one of those situations where you say, forget the politics. Politics be damned. Just do the right thing. Save as many lives as you can. Understand the practical reality about economic activity, and people have to work and people have to have a paycheck. And just do the right thing. This is not about politics, you know. This is about being able to sleep for the rest of your life, looking back at this moment and being able to say, I did the right thing. Mm. I saved lives. I saved as many lives as I could. You're going to get hit by both sides anyway. There is no win in this, right? You're going to have the people on one side saying you should have opened faster. You're going to have the other side saying if you didn't open, you would have saved lives. That's the way it's going to be. So forget what they say. I don't care what they, there is no they. It's this. And when it's over, that I can say, we did everything we could. The government did everything it should. We performed, we stepped up. We got the hospital beds built. We got the ventilators. We got the staff. And we saved the lives. And that's what we're going to do. So I don't really care, frankly, if the numbers say we should dial back the economic activity and the experts say we should dial it back, then we will do that. But Chris, and I'll say to the people of this state, look, you have no one to blame but the person in the mirror, because the economic activity will not increase the virus rate if people are smart. The mask, You want to hear a fascinating fact. First responders have a lower infection rate than the general population. Nurses in emergency rooms, doctors in emergency rooms, transit workers, NYPD, fire department, EMT, they have a lower infection rate than the general population. How can that be? They're the ones who are in the emergency room with the COVID positive people. The masks, the PPE works. And the sanitizer works, the hand sanitizer. If people do that, the infection rate will be fine. If we get undisciplined or sloppy, then you're going to see it go up. Mm.
I appreciate your candor on what's happening. It's going to be a very tough summer for people. There's a lot of frustration. There's a lot of expectation, but there's also a lot of fear. And that's a lot to balance. As leaders, thank you for coming on. Thank you for having a good sense of humor about what is a very important public service message. A lot of people aren't getting tested because they're worried about it. Thank you for showing people how easy it is to get tested. You're shaking your head in the negative. I'm not sure why.
That was not, you were beyond, don't call me, I'll call you.
What's wrong? I love you. I want you
Nothing.
To know that.
Nothing. I love you.
Have a good night. You. What are you looking at?
I have the screen. I have the screen right here.
I'm not doing
because
anything.
Because I don't trust you.
I'm not
so
doing
I had
anything.
To put in the screen.
Look at the screen.
Okay.
Look at the screen right now.
Yeah.
Yeah, you did.
Okay.
Yeah, there's nothing. Yes. I'll see you later. Have a good night, Gov.
Yeah.